ban will not cover tourist-related establishments. Tolentino told ANC hotels and bars can apply for an exemption from the ban. The proposal aims to lower the crime rate during the election period and minimize vehicular accidents due to drunk driving.
Coming next. Under Resolution Number 958, to which they issued last December 18, can likewise give liquor ban exemption, similar to the gun ban exemption, tourist-related establishment.
Okay.
This is the current exemption being granted by the Commission Election. The logic behind this is to really have a more intelligent campaign exercise, as well as to prevent road accidents. I foresee there would be a spike of road accidents during the campaign season,
yeah,
not just in Metro Manila, but in the provinces as well.
Commission on Elections Chief Sixto Brillantes, meanwhile, says the poll body is studying the proposal to extend the liquor ban. Brillantes expressed concerns businesses may be affected by a prolonged ban.
There might be a problem on the business side of it, no? Because even small stores do live on some sales of beer and all forms of liquor. So, baka maapektuhan. I'm trying to see whether we can actually expand the spirits provided for under the Omnibus Election Code.
Indiscriminate firing during New Year's Eve celebrations led to the death of several people, among them children. In Cavite, a man ran amok, killing 8 people. And just last week in Quezon, 13 men were killed in what reports now say may have been an ambush, if not a rubout. Muntinlupa Representative Rodolfo Biazon now joins us for his views on the firearm situation in the country and his calls for stricter gun control law. Senator, Congressman, good morning.
Good morning
to see you again, sir.
Good morning, Pinky. Good morning po sa lahat.
You know, looking back, Congressman, during the time that Presidential Political Affairs Ronald Diamas was arrested, he had 5 high-powered firearms. I remember that you were already quite vocal about having stricter gun control, especially for crime-related incidents. You were saying that we only need 2 guns. If anybody needs guns, the only thing they should only have 2 guns because we only have 2 hands, right?
That's correct.
Okay. What was you had filed a house bill on this?
Yes.
Okay.
As a matter of fact, I filed that even when I was still in the Senate, and it almost became law because the Senate passed it, but the House failed to follow through. That it did not become law. So when I moved over to the House of Representatives, I refiled the same bill.
Okay.
Except that my bill, and by the way, a House version was already approved 1 year ago.
Yeah.
That was January 24 of 2012.
Mm-hmm. And on third and final reading, but it didn't make it to the Senate. Right?
It was transmitted to the Senate on January 26, meaning 2 days after it was passed in. So we are waiting for the fate of this bill, as we had been waiting for the fate of many bills in this country that defines national interest. No? So we are waiting for the outcome of this. You know, the version that I filed were really stricter in the sense that I tried to define and limit the number of firearms that may be licensed to an individual.
Okay.
And define the limit of the caliber.
Really?
That may be allowed. Yes, correct. For example, I was saying that if we're talking of a rifle, it should not be more than 7.62 caliber.
Okay. That
maybe
I would tell you I don't caliber. Understand. Okay, 22 caliber.
Maybe 22 caliber, mm-hmm, for a rifle. Except that for the handgun, there is no
45.
Limitation. So mm-hmm, that was what I wanted to pass, no? Now we have the House version that allows for the licensing of weapons up to 7.62, including assault rifles. Now, what differs is, for example, in the House version, May be licensed with handguns, pistols, no? And then rifles.
A long firearm.
And there is a definition of rifles that are not on fully automatic mode.
Okay.
If one possesses such a weapon, his penalty, if caught in possession unlawfully of this weapon, he is to be punished. Yung reclusion, prison mayor.
Which is
8 years to 10 years. If he goes beyond 7.62 and fully automatic, then he can be punished with prison mayor, which is 10 years to 10 years to 12 years. Doon ang punishment niya.
Okay,
reclusion perpetua is imposed or meted out to anyone who is caught unlawfully possessing weapons that will require a crew to operate, like a machine gun,
okay,
for example, etc., etc. So we have the House version had increased the penalties, so to speak. But unfortunately, my attempt to limit the number.
Got it.
You know, there are five classes of licenses according to that proposed law. The first one is Class A, which allows a person to possess one handgun and one long rifle.
Okay.
Then Class B allows a person to own five. Class C allows a person to own 10.
Mm-hmm.
Class D,
15. E,
and
20.
Beyond 15 is Class E. Now, my question is, unfortunately,
is this per individual?
Kaya nga, there is no reference to a definition of who are qualified to have 2, 10, etc., etc. I would assume that beyond 2 or more than 2 will be allowed to gun clubs, security agencies, etc., etc. So, but however, this is not clearly defined in the proposed law. And I would assume that this is going to be eventually defined in the implementing rules and regulations.
But that's my question, sir. Yeah. Why must it be defined in the IRR and not in the bill?
That is correct. Well,
that's very broad.
Let's wait what the Senate will do.
Okay.
Number
so
one.
This is,
number two.
But, sir,
let's
sorry.
Wait.
This is the one pending right now.
This is the
this
House
is the
version.
One that was the transmitted to the Senate,
to the
and
Senate,
we're waiting
yes.
for a version
uh-huh.
of the Senate. Okay, uh-huh. so ito na yung House version. All uh-huh. right.
Now, let's wait for the version of the Senate.
Okay.
Let's wait for the version of the bicameral.
That's right.
And let's wait for the version of the implementing rules
the
and
IRR.
Regulations.
Mm-hmm.
I am going to try to attend that bicam.
Yeah.
That bicam.
All right. So, this version, I understand that there are about 20 versions pending in the House. So, tapos na pala sa, in Congress,
tapos
rather.
Tapos
na sa House.
Uh-huh.
That's just waiting. Any movement from the Senate or
that
any bill
correct.
From
that's
the Senate.
That's
I
correct.
Think there are a number of them also interested in this. I believe it, even Senator Lito Lapid is interested in gun control as well. Senator Bing Lacson.
That's correct. You know, how could an individual be allowed to possess 19 assault rifles
yeah.
as license to andal ang patuan? I wonder if there were forensic investigations to include ballistics
mm-hmm.
of the weapons that were used to kill, what, how many, 53?
Okay, yeah.
32 of them journalists?
58, I think.
58 yeah. or something. Mm-hmm. It's more than 50.
Yes,
anyway,
sir. Yes, sir.
So here, there is a lot of things to be done. And this should, I think, include to ensure that ballistics records
mm-hmm.
of especially registered weapons should be available for access in the event of any incidents. Unfortunately, there are supposed to be reported, it had been told to me this morning, 1.2 million registered firearms. Unfortunately, 562,000,
half of it,
did not re-register.
Renew the registration.
There is no renewal. So therefore, according to the police,
but
they should be considered as loose firearms.
They
already
should be, sir, if they're not re-registered.
That is correct.
They should be illegal,
That's correct. Now, the question is, what is the police doing? What is the government doing? Going after these people who initially registered but failed to renew.
Sir, number one, when you register a gun, obviously I don't have one, what is the renewal period? Every 1 year, 2 years, three years? Every year.
Every year.
You have to renew your gun every year. What about your permit to carry?
Well, the permit to carry is dependent on your personal circumstances. And for example, if you are a businessman, for example, you are allowed to carry it. You cannot. You may own. Excuse me. You may possess the weapon. You may be licensed.
Yeah.
For it.
But it doesn't mean you are allowed
mean
to
that
carry
you can,
it.
Yes, that is correct.
Okay.
No. But what wonder? What makes me wonder is, in the proposed law, why should this licensed weapon allowed to be carried outside of residence be concealed? It's a provision of the proposed law.
Yes, yes, yes.
To allow to carry and concealed.
Mm-hmm.
This one. I am wondering why it should be concealed.
Why? I don't understand
it
either.
Well, you know, the only reason that had been forwarded is that if you allow these people who are allowed to, who have licensed weapons and are allowed to carry out it outside of the residence, we could become a very scary society.
But
in the United States, it's different.
Mm-hmm.
You do not conceal it.
They don't, at all. Okay, let me ask you this, sir. You were chief of the AFP at some point. I understand even Senator Ping Lacson, of course, was PNP chief. Also, you're very, you are very adamant about gun control, gun-related crimes. Number one, apart from the calibers that you wanted,
limited,
and part of the bill, the House bill, which was excluded, you want only two guns.
That is correct.
Per civilian.
Per individual.
It's not just civilian,
It is not, per individual.
Okay.
We are talking of licensed guns.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, the military and the police are not licensed.
Mm-hmm.
They are not required to possess a license for the gun that they are authorized to. Mm-hmm.
Hindi sila kasali dito.
Hindi kasali.
Okay.
Kaya nga, isa yan doon dapat makita natin.
So,
ano?
So, the individuals would include, sir, let's talk about it. Bodyguards, security guards.
Yep.
Ano pa ba? You know, siguro members of
security
agencies.
Security agencies.
But apart from security agencies, who else normally carry?
CAFGO.
Okay. How about
CAA?
How about people?
Auxiliary?
How about people whose lives are in danger?
Well,
even if
that will have to be evaluated, yes. That
so, ganun din, they're included in that too. One short, one long. But obviously, in the House bill, hindi ganun ang nangyari.
Hindi ganun ang nangyari.
Okay. You know, when the Maguindanao massacre happened, this obviously brought to fore a lot of questions on private armies, etc.
That is correct.
You know, my question really is, sir, even if we have a good law on gun control, I'm really afraid of its implementation. Number one, how are you really going to check? Because a lot of the firearms are loose firearms.
That's correct.
You know, how can you really check that they only have two? I'm sure they have 10 or 15.
That is already law enforcement matter. You know, how the police operate or how the armed forces operate to effect the control on the guns.
Okay.
Yung sinasabi ko, about almost 600 weapons or firearms are considered to be loose firearms, unregistered.
Yeah.
So how do you control that? Yeah. I do not even know
exactly,
if
so.
the number is accurate.
Yeah, there might be even more.
That's correct.
And what happened, or maybe, sir, a good thing would also be, if you do not re-register or renew your license, maybe you would be blocked or disallowed from renewing it, you know, for some time. Because it's gun owners should be responsible owners. Hindi ba?
You know, yung may tinanong ko kanina sa security agencies, alam mo ba na ang yung nagpo-possess ng license is not the individual security guard.
It's the company.
It is the agency.
Yeah.
But there are rules, you know. For example, a security guard cannot take his gun home. It is supposed to be always in the
deposited
place of employment.
Okay.
Like,
so pagpa-uwi sila, sir, kunwari nasa convenience store, for example.
Yung magre-relief sa kanila, yun ang ita-turn over.
Okay.
Ngayon, kung wala yung relief at wala ng gwardiya pagkatapos niya, no? This is supposed to be put in a vault
in the place
where he's protecting.
Talaga, ganun ba?
Hindi pwedeng iuwi yan. Ang allowed
really
lang
carry
yan.
Hindi.
Okay. Now, ang allowed lang na magdala ng baril, yung protective security guards, meaning yung bodyguards. Kasi one, a civilian, anybody, can engage the services of bodyguards from the security, private security agencies. But I guess he will have first to justify it to the police.
That's right. You know, apart from that, sir, is that we really have to be strict. At least it's the leadership of the PNP.
Right.
It's the division. It's the firearms division and explosive division, I think.
Mm.
Number one, you know, sir, to be very honest with you, who really signs permits to carry? Who's really on top of gun control?
The FEO,
Firearms and Explosive Unit. Sila talaga.
Yeah, sila.
Okay, because they should be the one really talking to us about this. For example, sir, I did some research also. You know, at some point, when Senator Ping was, because I saw a story on him, was chief of the PNP, he said this, during his term, he allowed 600 PTCs, permit to carries, only. Because he was, I don't think he was very comfortable about PTCs, with PTCs. And there is a funny story because at some point, it was Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago, her husband, wanted the senator to be able to have a permit to carry. And Senator Ping Lacson at that time asked Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago to go to the office and do the written exam.
Yeah,
well, that's a true story.
That is a requirement. Yung,
But sir, do they do that now?
For example, now let's first go to the qualifications. Filipino citizen, 21 years old, psychiatric
drug test,
etc. There's a lot of
requirements.
And one of the requirements is that he passes the safety seminar on gun use.
Is that the written
to be
exam?
Administered by the police, number one, or an accredited gun club. That's a requirement in the grant of marami requirement yan. So here, if there is anyone who is against the uncontrolled proliferation of firearms, it's the police.
Yeah,
it's the problem.
Yeah, kaya, I agree with you.
Senator, I would understand Senator Lacson's thoughts on this when he was chief PNP, as it was also my concern when I was in the armed forces. Too many guns,
proliferating. Absolutely, sir. So, kaya nga, it starts there. Really, sir, when people like, for example, myself, I want to be a gun owner, I really need to do all the tests, seriously.
That's right.
I need to go there and really do the written exam. Hindi yung pupunta. You know, sir, it happens everywhere. LTO, for example, smoke test, drug test.
Yeah.
You know, these are laws in place, regulations in place, na pwedeng dayain, people can go around at ikutin. What more, the proliferation of guns. Okay, you think that you have 9 session days left, if I'm not mistaken, sir.
Right.
You go back to Congressman January 18?
21.
21. Yeah. So you have 9 session days left. Right. What can happen? Anyway, at least on your part, you're done with the gun control at the House.
Well, I don't know if it can still be, you know. If I am not very familiar with the status of the bill filed in the Senate, you know. And then you're talking of a bicameral,
true,
and then
sir.
Et cetera, et cetera. So I am looking at this in the same fate of the RS bill. If not today, maybe next time. I filed the RS bills 3 times.
Is that true?
In the Senate, and okay. Twice in the Senate, and once here in the House of Representatives.
I didn't know that, sir.
But it passed.
Yeah.
So maybe it will go through the same. You know, the question here is the police would like to control possession and carrying of weapons. There is the safety of the public as justification for that kind of sentiment. But there is a conflict of interest with who? Gun clubs?
Yeah.
Gun manufacturers? So it's still the same as in the United States.
Yeah.
Right now, after the Sandy Hook massacre of children, after that shooting in a mall, after the shooting in Chicago, after the shooting in et cetera, you know, the consciousness of the Americans now are being awakened on the need to study the amendment, Second Amendment to the Constitution, which allows or give the right to own weapons to prevent quote-unquote.
You know, that's true, sir, because that's a big debate in the United States now, the issue of gun gun control because of the recent spate of shootings all across the country. Well, this is the problem we have right now. So, 9 session days, sir, everybody will be busy with a campaign. You are running again for Congress in Muntinlupa. You're a second term, right? So, really, we just have to wait for the Senate. But then again, as you mentioned, after the Senate,
if the president certifies the bill,
Well, let's put it this way, sir. You have the campaign period. You know, it started last Monday. You have the checkpoints in and around the metropolis. Even those loose firearms, seriously, sir, you can't do anything about it right now.
May I one aside now? Itong gun control to be implemented by COMELEC has reference to local candidates, including me, mayors, etc., etc. My question is there a proper examination of the power of the mayor to use the police as bodyguards? Remember, even if the security is coming from the police, the mayor needs to get the go signal from the COMELEC. But the mayor has operational control over the police.
The mayor chooses who the chief of the PNP will be in their respective areas.
Right.
Who ba?
So I think that COMELEC must have to define this very clearly. I would not be against the proposition that during rallies, political rallies, the police must be there for obvious
safety.
Reasons, security of everyone. But what if the rally is mounted
against
by the rival of the
yeah.
What happens?
Sorry, na
correct.
Siya, di ba?
So I think that if indeed tomorrow you are going to have
the chairman,
maybe that is a question that should be asked.
Okay.
Governors, mayors, who have jurisdiction over operational jurisdiction over the police force. What about the opponent? This is a question.
You know, I want to leave you with one question, Congressman. You're a congressman right now. You're obviously not in direct control of the operations of the police. Are you for that kind of a system? Yung how the mayors actually have that control over who they will choose as chief of their the police in their locality.
Well, this is what the Constitution say. So, to me, as a matter of fact, I filed a bill for a split-level police force in this country. What do I mean by split?
What is that?
National and then local.
Okay.
Right. Unfortunately, the Constitution is very clear. We should have only one police force, national in scope, civilian in character.
Okay.
So, meaning, I did not really file
your
that bill.
Your bill will be unconstitutional.
That is correct. That's why I did not pursue it.
But I always thought, because, you know, I always thought that was a bit too, you know, that's tantamount to abuse of power, the kind of control local government officials have over the police.
In Spain, I just went there in relation to the peace process, you know, because we were studying the kind of power that may be given to the ARMM in relation to the police.
Okay.
In Spain, there are four levels of police: national, regional, provincial,
and local,
municipal.
Ah, okay.
But there is a problem. Okay. And I asked this question.
Who is their leader? Still the national.
It's the mayor, or the provincial governor, or the regional.
Okay.
And I raised the question of what are the powers of the mayors, governors, etc. They have the power to hire and fire the police, so that if a new mayor is elected, that mayor can fire and then get his own.
That sounds a little bit more chaotic to me. All right, Congressman Pong Biazon, sir, thank you so much for coming
thank
over.
Thank you for this.
You know, we'll talk about, let's see what happens to gun control. If it happens before the elections, it may seem not like it. But, you know, it always happens, sir. Every year, after New Year, something like this happens. Issue of gun control always comes up. We hope finally there could be some amendments or put an end to at least stiffer penalties on people.
If it does not pass this Congress, the 15th Congress, and if I will still be in the 16th Congress, I will refile it.
All right.
The same way I did with the RS bill.
Yeah.
I never
you will just
got
keep
tired
doing it and doing it and doing it. All right, Congressman. Again, thank you, sir. Good
thank
to see you.
Thank you, Pinky.
European Union Ambassador Aguilar Du talks about future projects and plans.